Namaste friends, today I am here to give you information about our great South Indian king Shri Krishnadevaraya. To begin with, the great kingdom of Vijayanagara was founded by Harihara and Bukkaraya under the patronage of their great guru Vidyaranya on the banks of the river Tungabhadra. Whenever we say as Krishnadevaraya, the first thing that comes to our mind that he was a benevolent ruler, a great scholar and patronage of art and architecture. He maintained Hampi as his capital. Hampi is a place located in Karnataka, India. This site is currently one of the most historic and popular sites of India. But the city is turned into complete ruins by the invasion of the Bahamani invaders of Talikotta, who looted the city till it went into ruins. Early life. Krishnadevaraya was born on 17th January 1471 in Hampi. He was the son of Tuluva Narasa Nayaka, an army commander under Saluva Narasimha Devaraya. He later took control of the empire and became the founder of Tuluva dynasty, the third Hindu dynasty to rule the kingdom of Vijayanagara. Krishnadevaraya succeeded him and brought the kingdom of Vijayanagara at its peak. He was the strongest ruler in India before the growth of the Mughal Empire. Krishnadevaraya's main enemies were the Bahamani Sultanates, whom he defeated and conquered the territories of Bidar, Gulbarga, Bijapur and Golconda. He defeated the Gajapatis of Odisha and occupied the territories in Andhra Pradesh. It was in his time that the Vijayanagara kingdom had expanded over the entire of South India. Tenali Rama. Tenali Rama was a courtier in Krishnadevaraya's court. He is popularly known for his wisdom, knowledge and his capability of understanding concepts and problems and giving others a suitable solution. Because of these qualities, he was later made as the Mantri of the kingdom. Art and architecture. Krishnadevaraya is also known for his architecture in temples in South India. He has constructed thousands of temples in South India. Some of the most popular temples constructed during his period are the world famous Tirumala Tirupati Venkateshwara Swami Temple, Virupaksha Temple in Hampi, Krishna Temple in Hampi, Vittala Swami Temple in Hampi, Kurudu Malay Ganesha Temple, Sri Shailam Temple and many other temples in South India. The reason behind these temples to still flourish is attributed to his patronage. He was also responsible for the emergence of a new architectural style called the Indo-Sassanic style of architecture. A notable style of this architecture is the Lotus Palace at Hampi. Each and every temple constructed under him has the Vijayanagara symbol, a boar, a sword and a moon. This symbol is present in most of the temples that are built under the patronage of Vijayanagara kings. He also had a great knowledge in the Kannada, Telugu, Tamil and Sanskrit literatures and he also composed many poems too. The peak of his empire was near his death when he had conquered the whole of South India. His final battle was with the Bahamani kings of Gulbarga. He died due to illness in 1529 and passed the kingdom to Achyutadevaraya, his brother. Krishnadevaraya is considered as a great king because he treated all the citizens in his kingdom as equal. But his greatness is not available in the present Indian history. I hope you have learned something and got some knowledge from watching this video. And I also hope that you'll help to spread this message by sharing this video to all others. Thank you for watching and also watch these remaining videos over here. MTR!